Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel. My name is Dr. Syed Heather, and today we are going to talk about on very common topic and a condition which is commonly seen in young girls and women. This condition is called endometriosis. Endometriosis is a condition where endometrial lining or endometrial tissue is present outside the uterus. If you are new to this channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share this video to your family and friends. Let's go back to our topic. And when the endometrial lining or endometrial tissue is present outside the uterus means anywhere in and around the uterus. So most common areas of endometriosis are fallopian tube, ovary, uterus, and the surrounding structure like ovarian ligament, broad ligament, pouch of Douglas, pelvic side walls, and also sometimes endometrial tissue or endometriosis is present in the bladder, urinary bladder, colon, sigmoid colon, or sometimes on the ureter as well. So what happens when the endometrial tissue is present outside the uterus? And patients usually complains of lots of symptoms related with pain, dyspareunia, bleeding, abnormal bleeding, and also pain when they are passing urine, you know, like they present, because if endometrial tissue is present on the bladder, so whenever the patient you know, pass the urine, or it causes pain because endometrial tissue is present there. And whenever, if the endometrial tissue is present on the colon, so whenever the bowel movements occur, you know, when patient go for the bowel movement, so whenever the you know, during the bowel movement, what happened, patient complained of severe abdominal and pelvic pain due to the movement of the bowel. So because endometriosis is present there, so that is the reason for the pain. And also, if the endometrial tissue is present on the pelvic side wall or peritoneum or uterine, so patients usually complain of severe lower abdominal pain, or patient complains of severe pelvic sidewall pain, okay, and sometimes a pain associated with the bleeding, uterine bleeding, or their periods are heavier than the normal, you know. And so let me show you the model here quickly, so in order to better understanding, you can understand better. You see this model, this is a uterine model. You see the uterus. The uterus has three linings. Innermost lining is called endometrium, which is shed during the maturation, or so we are talking about this endometrial tissue. Okay, so the first lining of the uterus is called endometrium, and another second lining is myometrium, which is a muscular wall of the uterus. And you see, most commonly you see when the fibroids occur, so uterine, this muscular wall is the most common part of the uterine fibroids, okay. And also you see, this is the right ovary and the left ovary, and ovaries are attached with the fallopian tubes, and fallopian tubes are attached with the uterus. So basically this endometriosis is linked with the linked with the menstrual cycle as well, okay. So because one of the theories that it's called retrograde menstruation. In retrograde menstruation, what happened, instead of menstrual cycle, endometrial shed outside the uterus through the vagina, what happened in retrograde means the backward, sometimes the backward movement of endometrial tissue occur, and backward, you see here, you know, in this model, the backward movement is, so you can imagine the uterine endometrial lining is going back. So when they go back, they can deposit an ovary, they can deposit in fallopian tube, and they can even deposit in the uterine ligament, and the surrounding structure like pelvic wall, bladder, and the colon. So that's why this is, you know, people are suspecting, or this is one of the theory, common theory, that they're retrograde, because we don't know the exact cause of endometriosis. But some people, you know, like think that due to the family history of endometriosis, you know, endometriosis is common. One theory just I discussed with you, the retrograde menstruation, and this is one theory, you know, this might be the cause of the endometriosis. All right, so because endometriosis is linked with the menstrual cycle as well, so we quickly discuss about the menstrual cycle. Menstrual cycle has four phases. First phase called a menstrual phase. In first phase, the endometrial lining is shed, and you know, the endometrium is secrete, or the lining secrete, or bleeding occur, and it goes out of the vagina. The second phase is called the follicular phase. In follicular phase, what happened? The follicles of ovary, you know, follicles of ovary, you see the follicles ovary, in second phase basically act on the ovarian follicle. They prepare the ovarian follicle for the ovulation, and this process is also linked with the our hormonal action, like female hormonal actions. So what happened, you know, what happened in our brain? There is one area called hypothalamus. Hypothalamus secrete all the hormone. Hypothalamus release the hypothalamic releasing hormone. You know, almost majority of hormones are come from the hypothalamus, and hypothalamus linked with the anterior pituitary. So in this scenario, what happened? Hypothalamus secrete the hormone called gonadotropin releasing hormone. So when the gonadotropin releasing hormone release, gonadotropin release hormone release from hypothalamus, and it act on anterior pituitary, and anterior pituitary release hormones called FSH and LH, follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. So when the follicle FSH and LH release into the blood, and through the blood they act on the ovary, and they act on the ovary, and they stimulate the secretions of ovarian hormone, which are like estrogen, progesterone, androgen. All right, so that's why when you go to see your doctor, uterine fibroids are non-cancerous growth in and around the uterus, and they are sometimes known as a myoma, uterine myoma, or leiomyomas as well. Most common symptoms of uterine fibroids are heavy and painful periods, lower abdominal pain, lower back pain, frequent urinations, constipations, and they are also cause infertility. Infertility is one of the most common complication of uterine fibroids. And what happen if the fibroids is large? They block the uterine, they block the tube. So if the due to blockage of the tube, fertilization does not occur here in the uterine cavity. All right, so if we talk about what is the reason for fibroids development, so the exact cause of fibroids is still unknown, but the fibroid development is linked with the estrogen production. Estrogen is one of the female reproductive hormone produced by the ovaries. So fibroids usually develop during the reproductive year in around 16 to 50 years. So, but after this age, due to the estrogen level is low, so that's why after this age, like after 50 years or at the menopause age, they usually shrink, or the chances of getting fibroids after the age of 50 is low. So as I said, fibroid development is linked with the estrogen produced by the ovary. So as you get older, the production of estrogen is lower, so there are chances of getting fibroids is lower as well. So also, if we talk about, there are different types of fibroids. Main are like intramural fibroids. They are most common type of fibroid, which develop in the muscle wall of the uterus. These are called intramural fibroids, subserosal fibroids. They develop outside their uterus. These are called subserosal, and sometimes they develop outside the uterus here. And some mucosal fibroids, they develop in the muscles there. We need some mucosal hair, like these are, this places is for some mucous fibroid as well, but the muscle layer is majority of intramural fibroids develop in this muscular wall of the uterus. Or this is basically if we talk about how to treat fibroids, because what happened, fibroids sometimes don't need any treatment because they do not cause any symptoms. And after the age of menopause, they will often shrink without any treatment. All right, so there are also some medications that are available which people use for the fibroid treatment, and sometimes people go for the surgical treatment where they remove the fibroid from the uterus. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you like this video, please hit the like button and share this video to your family and friends. And if you have any questions related with this video, please feel free to ask any questions in the comment box, and we will definitely answer your questions. Thank you so much.